Ben Affleck is hands down my favorite actor and longtime celebrity crush. The man has 4 movies coming out this year, one of which was just released called The Way Back, and I can't wait to see it. Ben is an award-winning writer, director, and of course a great actor. With a career spanning over 2 decades, he's amassed a multi-million dollar net worth and of course invested some of that into real estate. Currently, Ben is living in a gorgeous mansion in Pacific Palisades worth over $19 million. In this video, we're gonna take a look at that place as well as some of his other real estate. Ben Affleck is an actor and filmmaker who's won multiple awards, some include 2 Oscars and 3 Golden Globes. At the time of this recording, he's 47 years old, and although he started acting as a child, he didn't gain wide recognition until the 90s. Ben and his childhood friend slash fellow actor Matt Damon won for Best Original Screenplay writing Good Will Hunting in 1997, which they also starred in. Since then, Ben has been the leading man in many blockbuster films, and his directorial debut came with the movie Gone Baby Gone in 2007. From there, he directed and starred in The Town and Argo. Maybe I'm biased, but I think they're all amazing films. Ben is also co-founder of the Eastern Congo Initiative, which is a grant-making nonprofit, and he co-owns the production company Pearl Street Films alongside Matt Damon, not to mention he's the father of 3. The newly released sports drama Ben's starring in, The Way Back, mirrors some real-life issues he's opened up about. Although he's currently sober, Ben has had a struggle with alcohol addiction, just like the character in the film. Another thing they have in common is dealing with a divorce, and Ben has said about his own experiences. I drank relatively normal for a long time. What happened was that I started drinking more and more when my marriage was falling apart. This was 2015, 2016. My drinking, of course, created more marital problems. But we aren't talking about Ben's personal life today, although I think he's brave for being so open and honest. His list of accomplishments goes on, and his hard work has allotted him an estimated net worth of $130 million. Of course, he used some of that fortune to buy his real estate. Hey guys, it's Karen. Today we're doing another house tour here on Famous Entertainment. We're gonna see where Ben Affleck calls home, like his mansion or bachelor pad in Pacific Palisades and more. If you like these videos, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell to be notified when we post so you can always be up to date. We've also done house tours on the likes of Johnny Depp and Brad Pitt, and we'll have links to those at the end of this. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram because I love connecting with you guys. I've also been reading all your comments and I'm gonna be responding to some at the end. I need you to let me know who to do next in the comments down below and whose home you'd like to see. Now let's get into this video. Although Ben was born in Berkeley, California, he spent most of his life in Massachusetts, moving there when he was 3. It seems that his life path brought him right back to the West Coast, but as an A-list actor, of course living close to Hollywood and in California is a no-brainer. Before we see his current home, Ben lived in the same area prior to his divorce from actress Jennifer Garner. The couple bought this house back in 2009 for $17.6 million and lived there with their 3 children. It was located in the Pacific Palisades, which is an upscale neighborhood between the Santa Monica Mountains and the Pacific Ocean, definitely offering some beautiful views of the coast. The ranch-style mansion sits on more than 3 acres of land and was built back in the 1930s by architect Cliff May. Ben and Jen had a ton of renovations done to the house since purchase, but when they first moved in, it had 5 beds and 8 baths. The main house was 8,800 square feet spread over a sprawling single level, and there were 2 more structures on the property. One building had an office, art studio, gym, and 2 baths, and there was also a subterranean guest house with 2 beds and 3 baths. Not to mention the guest house had an entertainment lounge and movie theater. Some other features on Ben and Jen's former estate included a canyon view terrace, a swimming pool with open air cabana, massive lawn, and a half court basketball court. Although Ben and Jen were asking $45 million for the mansion, they sold it to none other than Maroon 5 frontman Adam Levine, and apparently he got a deal for $32 million. Once upon a time, not too long ago, Ben also owned a massive and fancy estate in Georgia. This remote and spaced out property served as his hideaway for many years, and he bought it way back in 2003 while still dating J-Lo. Seems like ancient history now. Ben got this place for just over $7.1 million and it's located in Riceboro, Georgia, on the exclusive Hampton Island Preserve. It sits along the North Newport River just off the coast of Georgia and contains 3 separate homes. The main house is a white Greek Revival style mansion that spans 6,400 square feet of living space, also known as the Big House. First thing I noticed were the large pillars on the outside of the Big House. and moving inside, the breathtaking entryway features bowl columns as well. The big house has 4 beds and 4.5 baths spread across 2 levels. Everything about the main house on Ben's estate is elegant. The big house was made to resemble the traditional southern plantation homes, and it definitely does. More historically accurate features include 15-foot ceilings, pine floors, and arched fireplaces. Some rooms include a kitchen, large dining room, and even a gentleman's study. Leaving the mansion from the back porch, you can walk along a brick path to the river. Then to the right, you'll find the Oyster House. So Ben's main house here was clearly called the Big House, yet this second structure is 10,000 square feet, so technically it's bigger. This rustic guest house is designed in a camp style and features 5 bedrooms, 3 of which are master suites, and 2 have bunk beds made from merchant seaship wood. The Oyster House is surrounded by glass windows and a wraparound balcony, and also features an entertainment space. The third and final building at Ben's Georgia estate is called the Summer Cottage. It's a single-story house with a metal roof located beside a shell path. The home features a large screened-in room with a fireplace perfect for summer entertaining, such as outdoor feasts or fish fries. Inside the summer house, there are pitched ceilings, oversized fireplaces, and stone floors, which give it a cozy country feel. There's also a full kitchen, multiple seating areas, and a large deck. Finally, somewhere else on Ben's previous property, there's a private dock complex with open-air boathouse. There you'll find a 38-foot mahogany sport fishing boat that's permanently docked there, and it can also serve as a unique guest quarters if you're low on space. Ben's Georgia plantation estate and mansion was definitely the perfect getaway, and personally, I really like the historic and classic style. Unfortunately, I guess he wasn't spending enough time relaxing there anymore, and put it on the market for just under $8 million. Of course, following Ben's divorce, he needed to get himself a bachelor pad. When I hear bachelor pad, I usually think of a condo or something along those lines, but in Ben's case, it meant a mansion close to $20 million. In 2018, it was reported that Ben put down $19.25 mil on an estate in the Pacific Palisades area of California, where their previous family home was. Like I said before, this neighborhood sits on the coastline and is absolutely gorgeous and exclusive. Ben's mansion is designed in a New England style, but also has some very LA features too. The interior is 12,853 square feet spread over 3 floors, and he has 7 beds, 6 full baths, and 2 half baths. It's super private, which you would hope when that kind of cash is involved. It sits on almost a third of an acre of land and backs onto the Riviera Country Club, and of course is fully gated. Inside Ben's mansion, you'll find a grand entryway with double height ceilings and a sweeping curved staircase, as well as a spacious living room with a black marble fireplace. Other main living spaces in the home include a large dining room with space for a dozen guests or more, family rooms including one with a white marble fireplace, and a large kitchen fitted with black countertops, a snack bar, and a breakfast nook. Not to mention, beside the kitchen, there's a neighboring den that could double as staff quarters, and a wood-paneled study or library with a wet bar. Ben's Pacific Palisades bachelor pad also has room for his 3 kids and then some. On the second floor of this home, there are 3 family bedrooms and even a children's family room. Sounds like the perfect amount. Of course, Ben also has an impressive master suite complete with a sitting area, 2 walk-in closets, and 2 marble bathrooms. And if you thought that was a lot, Ben also has a basement in this massive home. It's finished exactly as nice as the upper floors, and has a lounge and games room, walk-in wet bar, and climate-controlled wine cellar. Not to mention, there's a 12-plus seat home movie theater, a large gym, and a secluded staff suite. Moving outside his house, there's a big lawn and outdoor kitchen, and a fireplace at the other end. Plenty of greenery and trees give the home additional privacy, and there's also a swimming pool, just like any good house in Los Angeles. The added guest house on Ben's property is about 600 square feet and even has its own separate kitchen and bathroom. So now we've seen Ben Affleck's living quarters, including the Pacific Palisades mansion he bought in 2018 after splitting with Jen. Although it looks like more than enough space for a single dad, he's made enough money to buy any size mansion he wants. Prior to moving into this home, Ben was apparently renting a place around the same area since it was close to where Jen lives with the kids. I wonder which parent has a nicer mansion now, but looking at Ben's, it seems hard to compete with. What was your favorite part of his current house? I think the basement is mine. I mean, it looks massive, and I would love to have that gym and movie theater in my place. Alright guys, now I'll be reading out some of your comments from previous videos. On our recent Vanessa Bryant house tour, Matrice said, "The Bryant's house is so breathtaking, their home is my dream home. So stylish, glamorous, beautiful, and classy family." On our Jessica Simpson before and after video, Sandra Garcia left a couple comments and wrote, "I love Jessica forever, I love your channel. Thanks, Sandra, for the nice comment. I love Jessica too. And finally, on the updated Jeffree Star before and after video we just did, Dan Lebrecht commented, "No offense to Jeffree, I'm a fan of his, but he went from some ugly dude to a beautiful man, lol." For some reason, that comment made me laugh when I read it earlier. I love Jeffree too, but Dan, you certainly have a point. Alright guys, that's all I could find on Ben Affleck's mansion in the Pacific Palisades, as well as the mansions he used to own. Which place did you guys like the best? Honestly, I think my personal fave was his Georgia getaway. I love the classy and historic style, and also how each house on the property had a different vibe. Looked like a relaxing vacation spot for sure. Let me know in the comments as well as what other celebrity houses you'd like to see. Follow me on Instagram if you want to chat more, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!